The day has finally come. Hello everybody on the internet. We have finally gotten the trailer for Avengers Infinity War. This trailer is utterly mind-blowing. It's just destroying the internet. This trailer is just incredible. Thanos looks like an incredible villain. Josh Brolin sounds so great in that role. His dialogue in this is great. Thanos looks impossible to defeat. But there is so much more to this movie that this trailer doesn't even showcase. This trailer only scratches the surface of the scale and everything that's going to be in this movie. It's impossible to really give the audience a big idea of what this movie is in a trailer. And I mean it when I say it. This trailer is incredible. The dialogue, the music, everything that's happening in it is just incredible. There really is some great dialogue in this trailer. Like at the beginning of the trailer. It's a throwback to Nick Fury's monologue in the Avengers. All the different characters are saying a line from it. It's just great. And the music in that part is great too. It really gives you a feeling of how bad the situation is. And the plot and where the characters are. They're divided and they're going up against the greatest threat ever. The way this trailer is set out is really good. Like it starts off in a certain way and then goes up to an epic level. It just showcases characters, like where they are at this time, and then it shows like all these different stuff happening, like an epic battle in Wakanda going on. Like, oh, I cannot wait to see that. At the start of the trailer, we see Tony Stark holding somebody's hand in like a destroyed environment, and it definitely looks like a character has died, but we don't know who. This is pretty cool. We see that Hulk has crashed into the Sanctorum and turned back to Bruce Banner, and Bruce Banner's looking up. And Doctor Strange and Wong are there, and they're just like, what? And there's a big hole in the roof behind them. That is just like something that happened in the Infinity Gauntlet comic. When Silver Surfer crash landed into the Sanctum Sanctorum to warn Doctor Strange about the coming of Thanos. So I reckon that they're going to do something like that, but with Hulk. Because as seen in the after credit scene of Thor Ragnarok, Thanos' ship shows up to the Asgardian ship, and Hulk is on that ship, so that something that Thanos does must send Hulk all the way back to Earth, and he tries to tell Doctor Strange and that about what's coming. And this was really unexpected. We see Vision in human form. That's right out of the comics. In the comics, he had a holographic human disguise form, and he went by the name Victor Shade. I don't know if this is going to be a hologram. Maybe it's technology, or maybe it's the power of the Infinity Stone in his head. And we don't even know if he's going to go by the name Victor Shade. But this is really interesting that they've included this. This is a really cool shot. Wong, Doctor Strange, Bruce Banner, and Iron Man all standing together in the Sanctum Sanctorum. And you can see where Hulk fell behind them. It's going to be really cool to see Iron Man and Doctor Strange interact. And this confirms that Loki took the Tesseract when he went into Odin's vault to put Surtur in the Eternal Flame in Ragnarok. And it looks like Loki is presenting the Tesseract to Thanos, about to hand it over to him. This shot is so cool. Spider-Man is finally wearing the Iron Spider suit, because he's going to need it to go up against the greatest threat the universe has ever known. But later on, we see that Spider-Man's wearing his suit and being slammed on the ground by Thanos. Oh man, Spider-Man doesn't stand a chance against Thanos. And relating to that shot I first talked about, that looks like the same environment. And Thanos has just slammed Spider-Man on the ground. And in the leaked trailer, there was a shot of Iron Man looking down at Spider-Man and Spider-Man saying, Tony, I'm sorry. So maybe Spider-Man dies, because that's what it looks like. I don't know how that's going to work, because he already has a sequel confirmed, so who knows. I have no idea what Thor is doing in this shot, but this is very reminiscent of Captain America in Civil War, holding that, trying to pull that helicopter down that Bucky was in. And this is also really cool. Iron Man has a brand new Hulkbuster suit. Oh, look at that. That is so cool. It looks quite different. Like, the shape of everything is quite different. And it looks a little bit bulkier. But I don't think this suit will be used to fight the Hulk again. It will be used to fight Thanos and the Black Order. For sure. This shot is awe-inducing, but we all saw it coming. Corvus Glaive and Proxima Midnight are trying to rip the Infinity Stone out of Vision's head. And he's screaming in pain. We know that's Corvus Glaive because look at that weapon. That's Corvus Glaive's weapon. And look at his feet. That's Corvus Glaive's feet. And the weapon right next to Corvus Glaive's weapon is Proxima Midnight's weapon. We also know this from set photos and set footage. And this shot here shows Thanos putting the Tesseract in Infinity Stone form on the gauntlet. And look at that. There's already one Infinity Stone on the gauntlet before that. And that is the Power Stone. That means the first stone that Thanos gets his hands on is the Power Stone that was in Guardians of the Galaxy. That means Thanos is going to have to go to Xandar and, like, decimate the Nova Corps and to get to the stone. And I reckon that's a way how the Guardians are going to come into the plot of this movie. We get so many epic shots. We get the army of Wakanda and the Avengers fighting a swarm of alien creatures who are called the Outriders. And their only purpose is to serve Thanos until they die. And they're going to be a bigger threat than the Chitauri for sure. We get Captain America punching one, Black Panther clawing one, and then Thanos punching Iron Man so hard that pieces of his helmet break off. And then the most epic shot would have to be Captain America, Black Panther, Winter Soldier, Black Widow, War Machine, Hulk, Falcon, a member of the Dora Milaje, and the Wakandan army charging. It's such an epic shot. I really can't say enough about it. And then at the very end of the trailer, we see Thor meeting the Guardians of the Galaxy, and Mantis just gives him a little wave. And look, Groot's a teenager. That's going to be so cool to see. Just the Guardians interacting with the Avengers is just going to be awesome and really funny, for sure. This was by far one of the best, if not the best, trailers of the year. It just got me even more hyped than I already was. So what did you think of this trailer? Let me know in the comments below. And live long and prosper.
Who the hell are you guys?